Hey guys, what's up? This is Geronimo and thank you for watching this video. And for today, tuturuan ko kayo kung paano ba natin makukuha yung mga blurry backgrounds natin na pwede nating magamit if we want to post photos or videos on our Instagram or other social media platforms. So if gusto mong matutunan itong mga bagay na ito, please keep watching this video. So for today, we have three parts for this video. Kasi I think these three subjects, yung pinaka nakaka-apekto sa photos or videos natin para magkaroon ng blurry backgrounds. So let's go to the first one, yung aperture. Syempre kapag alam naman natin the lower our F value or yung F number or yung aperture value natin, the blurry background yung makukuha natin. For example, I'm using an F1.8 or F1.2, yung pinaka-max na nagamit nating aperture na. So mapapansin nyo talaga yung creaminess ng bokeh or yung blurry background na nakukuha natin sa photos or videos na sinushoot natin. And if tinaas natin yung F-value natin, dun tayo nagkakaroon ng sharper image or video footage. So for example, dito sa frame na nakikita nyo ngayon sa video natin, I'm using an F8 aperture value, and kung mapapansin nyo, hindi blur yung background ko. Why? Because if I use a lower F-value, makikita nyo na blown out yung sky na nasa background ko. So that's one thing na pwede natin consider when we use the aperture setting. So with that being said, just use a lower F value if you want to have those blurry backgrounds sa photos or videos nyo. Next is the distance between our subject and the background. So hindi lang aperture na nakaka-apekto, kundi pati rin yung distance. So if you don't have those lenses na merong F1.8 or F1.2 or at least F2.8, then you can maximize the distance between your subject and the background para magkaroon kayo ng blur background doon sa photo or video nyo. So next time na magkukuha kayo ng photo or video and you are limited with your lens or with the gear that you are using, you can use the distance between your subject and the background. Going to the next and our third part of this video, which is the focal length. Yes, tama kayo. Our focal length sa lens natin, nakaka-apekto din siya kung gaano ka-blur yung background ng subject na kinukuhanan natin. For example, you're just using an F4 lens, pero meron siyang focal length of 100 up until 200 millimeter. So if minaximum mo yung focal length na yon, most probably makakuha ka ng bokeh background sa image or footage mo. So if you want to get those blurry background and you're limited with an F4 value or F3.5, and if you're using a kit lens or a variable lens like F3.5 to F6.3 tapos limited kayo sa F6.3, then check if kaya mong umabot ng 100mm or up until 200mm para mas compress yung background mo and nagkakaroon siya ng blurry effect o yung tinatawag nating bokeh. Okay? So next time na sobrang limited ka sa aperture mo and you want those bokeh, just check first yung distance between your subject and the background, and next is your focal length. So sometimes dun sa kit na kasama ng EOS R ko, nakakuha ko ng talagang creamy, blurry background even though F4 lang yung aperture, or I mean yung widest aperture na pwede makuha ng lens na yon. So meron kayong mga sample na nakita ngayon na talagang mapapansin nyo, creamy talaga yung background niya even though F4 lang siya. Kasi nga, yung focal length nito at yung distance nito sa background is na-consider din. So I'm using most probably 105mm dito para magkaroon ng ganitong blurry background. Then last thing is, I mean, bonus part of this video you might want to consider in the future is that using a full frame camera. So iba yung F4 ng full frame camera sa F4 ng APS-C and the Micro Four Thirds. So you might want to test and try kung gaano ka laki yung difference between those two, pero they have their differences between the depth of field of a full frame camera, a crop sensor camera, and also a Micro Four Thirds camera. So I do prefer using a full frame since nung nagkaroon ako ng full frame camera kasi ayun, nasanay na yung mata ko doon sa depth of field na binibigay ng EOS R, which is ginagamit ko rin siya ngayon. So that's it for today guys. I hope na may natutunan kayo sa video na to, a very quick one. And also, if you want to use those blurry backgrounds, kung gusto mo na mas malalim na depth of field, just make sure na nakafocus yung photos nyo sa mga, kung nagsushoot kayo ng portrait is sa mata, and if nagsushoot kayo ng mga pet, syempre sa mata or sa ulo man lang. So make sure na sharp pa rin yung subject nyo, kasi minsan sa sobrang blur or sa sobrang shallow ng depth of field natin is hindi na nakafocus yung subject natin. So please keep in mind those points. So that's it for today, guys. Thank you for watching this video. I hope na may natutunan ka, and I hope na nagustuhan mo tong video na to. And if nagustuhan mo, don't forget to click the like and share button. Also, if you want to support this channel and me creating more videos in the future, meron din tayong Buy Me a Coffee site link in our description box below. We do have our membership plan also, so click nyo lang yung join button if you want. And if you want to learn more about photography, videography, editing, and vlogging, please consider clicking the subscribe button. Malaking tulong yon sa channel na ito. That's all for today, guys. Once again, this is Jeff Geronimo. Thank you for watching this video. See you on the next one. Bye. Peace.